In the face of so many obstacles along the path to peace and of the disastrous consequences of war, consequences such as peoples forced to abandon everything, especially in the Middle East, the proliferation of arms trafficking, lack of respect for the human person, Christians are called to share the gospel in a coherent way with the whole world. That was the message of Pope Francis during an ecumenical gathering devoted to prayer for peace in Yerevan's Republic Square. By his side was the Armenian Catholicos Karekin II, who echoed his remarks. Pope Francis said, "Unity is not concerned with strategic advantages sought out of mutual self-interest. Rather, it is what Jesus requires of his disciples, who are called to lay aside rigid opinions in the name of humble love, putting aside suspicion and mistrust. Beneath the gaze of Mount Ararat, where tradition says Noah's Ark came to rest after the flood, Pope Francis recalled once more the Metzia Cairn, the great evil, which remains impressed in our memory and burns in our hearts. He expressed his hope that it might be remembered as a perennial warning, lest the world fall back into the maelstrom of similar horrors. This land, the Pope said, dotted with crosses of stone and bathed in the blood of innocents, shows that even the greatest pain, transformed by the saving power of the cross, can become a seed of peace for the future." He continued, "We would all benefit from efforts to lay the foundations of a future that will resist being caught up in the illusory power of vengeance, a future of constant efforts to create the conditions for peace." It was an invitation addressed especially to the young, that they might be peacemakers, not content with the status quo, but active promoters of a culture of encounter. "May God bless your future," he said, "and grant that the people of Armenia and Turkey take up once again the path of reconciliation. And may peace spring up once more in Nagorno-Karabakh."